Hey, come in.
Yes, come in.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Mr. Sinha, are you working?
No, sir.
No. So, 2016 you finished. Then, okay. So, why do you wish to join the civil service?
Sir, civil services provides in many ways a unique opportunity to directly participate in the process of nation building, and it provides a good career opportunity as well.
Very cheap. So it combines both a good career as well as opportunity for public service.
Yes, sir.
So what qualities will you bring to this job?
Sir, I feel I'm a man of principles. I feel I can think logically. I have a problem-solving approach. And I think, sir, I can bring efficiency, good integrity, as well as other factors which I think makes me a suitable candidate for it.
What is the GDP growth rate of Jharkhand?
The nominal growth rate is about 12%. The real growth rate around 8%.
Good. So it's very good. How is it that it has been able to register such good growth rate?
So one important reason is that we have a lot of resources. And if we have the right policy framework, then these resources can be utilized well. So that is happening via schemes like Momentum Jharkhand that we had, other kind of investment promotion schemes. That's one. Secondly, one main reason where Jharkhand improved itself was the agriculture sector, by improving the coverage of the agricultural revolution to the eastern side of India. And Bihar and Jharkhand both improved in this. Thirdly, because of the formation of new state of Ranchi, a construction sector, new city capital of Ranchi, the construction sector in particular, it was boosted by a lot, and that in turn helped the growth, the state to grow by a lot.
Yeah, sir.
Can you tell us how does our constitution ensure and guarantee social justice?
So the main is by the articles of Article 14, 15, 16. Which combines the principle of equality with justice wherever required. On top of it, we have special provisions like Article 29 and Article 30, which ensures social justice, even including Article 25, 26, for the people of religious minorities.
Yes.
Similarly, Article 39, Article 40, 41, and the other directive principles, they in turn incentivize and nudge the state to ensure that social justice is undertaken.
Okay, can you tell us what was this Indira Sahni judgment?
Sir, the core idea was about the reservation of people from the OBC category. And regarding that, the Honorable Supreme Court upheld the reservation for the OBC category while stating that reservation based on income cannot be allowed.
Okay. That was the first time OBC was given reservation. At the central level.
Yes, sir.
Now, OBC stands for other backward classes. How did caste come into picture?
So there's generally a correlation between caste and class. And it was believed that caste and class, with backward classes also, backward castes also make up the backward classes. Secondly, the principle of creamy layer and the principle of non-creamy layer, it explicitly introduced the object of class into the caste factor, sir.
Why do we need All India Services?
So the principal idea is to have a universal brotherhood and synergy between all the states of the country, as well as the center and the states. So to uphold the federal principles and to uphold the integrity of the country, All India Services provides a good link. And secondly, because they have served across many states across the center, it helps to reciprocate some of the best principles in the other states and at the central level as well, sir.
Representation of People Act, it has some provisions to keep away people with criminal antecedents from the electoral politics. Can you say something about that?
Yes, sir. So basically, any criminal who has been penalized or who has been convicted for a jail term greater than 2 years is ineligible to participate in election for the next 6 years or so, I think. The exact year, I think, I mean.
6 years after he completes the sentence.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And there was a judgment by the Supreme Court, Lily Thomas. Are you aware of what was that judgment?
So the judgment basically changed the Article 8, the Section 8D of the RP Act, and it said that earlier provision was that anyone could apply for an appeal in the Supreme Court, and a 3-month window is provided for that. At that point of time, in case the appeal is upheld, in that case there won't be outlawed.
It discriminated between sitting legislators and others. Last,
yes,
what is the controversy with regard to electoral bond?
So on one hand, the controversy is that there is a lot of anonymous funding, about 69% as per the ADR report, 89% comes from the corporate funds. So the question is that electoral bonds will help to ensure that white money comes in the system. However, the controversy from the other side is that it still does not solve the issue of corporate funding, because the people, the donations are...
Thank you.
Abhijeet.
Yes.
Economics is your optional.
Yes, sir.
If I make a statement that loan waiver, or not loan waiver, by some states, it may be good politics but bad economics. Please say something about this. And what do you say? You agree or you disagree? Whatever you say, you just.
So I agree to a significant extent to it. It is good politics because it's a popular mission. It helps to mobilize votes, it helps to mobilize the aspirations of the people at the bottom, and in that way the political dividends can be high. It may not be a good economic policy because of the reasons that this creates a problem of moral hazard, and in future banks may be unwilling to lend to these poor people. Secondly, it also creates a lot of it raises the stockpiling of the non-performing assets in future, and the government fiscal cost also increases. In that way, the economic costs can be high. But nonetheless, sir, in extreme times, I think we need extreme measures. Even as the Supreme Court has recently said,
so loan waiver should be done
in extreme cases, sir. Not.
What do you mean by extreme case? Every time, farmers are having distress. There are suicide conditions. That means there should be loan waiver every year.
So I think we can have an objective criteria.
Government would always like to, the government of the day would always like to say this is an extreme case. So you are neither here nor there. This statement is a political statement, right?
So we can have a threshold. Like for example, if the drought level is above, this is this more intense than
like
this.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. What are the main thrusts of this budget? If I want you to say 3-4 major thrusts of this budget.
So the principal thrust is on the health sector, and on that we have the Ayushman Bharat program.
No. You name the thrusts.
Sure, sir.
Healthcare
is one. Education is another. Agriculture and rural development is another thrust area. And fourthly, we have the MSME sector.
Okay. Tell me, in agriculture, what is the budget thrust? What all has been announced in this budget? Agriculture.
Yes. Sir, one major announcement has to be to raise the MSP level to level of cost plus 50%. That's one.
What is this cost?
The cost currently the government says is A2 plus FL. However, many want it to be raised to the C2 levels.
Okay, that is one is MSP, you say, in agriculture.
Yes,
then what else?
The second is the Operation Greens.
What is this Operation Greens?
It's a program to ensure that three crops, tomato, onion and potato, their production is increased and price volatility is reduced by providing some FPOs, cold storage units, etc. Thirdly, we have special missions for bamboo. We have funds for the animal husbandry sector and the fisheries sector together.
What they have told about bamboo?
There's a national bamboo mission, and I think 10,000 crore has been given to expand the ambit of this fund and the scheme. And lastly, sir, we have a provision to expand the rural market, rural mandi, under the program of grams, and to connect more of them through the e-numbers.
How many?
The exact figure I don't know, sir.
So 22,000.
Yes, thank you, sir.
Okay. So these are the things in agriculture. Okay. What is Sagarmala project?
So it's an umbrella project to ensure that our port infrastructure that is modernized, more modern ports are created, more evacuation network is improved, and to ensure that industries and special zones in the coastal areas can be set so that even the people in living in these coastal areas can be improved and growth and development can take place.
Anything about the hinterland?
Yes, sir. The evacuation network is also improved so that the connectivity from the hinterland is expanded.
Okay.
You're from Jharkhand.
Yes, ma'am.
And we hear about the LWE, the left-wing extremism. How is it that your state is still reeling under this problem?
Ma'am, the main reason why we are still dealing is because I think there will rest in an empty mind, and that can happen if there is a lack of education, if there is a poverty, and if there are genuine concerns like land alienation, environmental concerns, mining related displacement issues, and this provides a fertile ground for Naxalites propaganda to spread. Secondly, nonetheless, ma'am, we are, I think, improving on that regard, and the surrenders, the total number of casualties, all have seen a significant improvement. So we are behind, but we are improving.
And there's something known as the Red Corridor, which still exists. What is the Red Corridor? Which are the states which are affected by LWE?
Red Corridor is basically a region which is still under the significant control of Naxalism. Mm. So we have states like Bihar, Jharkhand, West Bengal to a certain extent, Odisha, Chhattisgarh, Telangana region, to some extent Andhra Pradesh region, and some
even Andhra Pradesh not so much.
Yes.
Okay, tell me that your state is very rich in resources, yet it hasn't progressed, especially even since bifurcation. What is the reason?
Ma'am, resources are a necessary factor for growth, but they are not a sufficient factor for growth. You also need other kind of resources like water. We need other kind of improvements like porting. The infrastructure should be good.
What about good governance?
It is in fact
stable
a very good factor, ma'am.
Politics?
Yes, ma'am. Mm-hmm. Yes, ma'am. So altogether, this is needed for us to ensure that we can leverage our resources.
So you studied in Kanpur.
Yes, ma'am.
You would have seen the Ganga River there.
Yes.
How clean or dirty was it? Very dirty?
Not very dirty. My expectation was more. But I think because the volume of the river is very high, the dirt visibility is sometimes less.
So we have a lot of schemes. We've had a lot of schemes over the years to clean the Ganga. And now we have the latest known as the Namami Gange scheme. Can you tell me something about this scheme, the Namami Gange project?
Ma'am, it's basically a scheme to ensure that Ganga and its tributaries are clean and sanctified. For that, we have many schemes.
What are its components?
And one is to expand the infrastructure such as sewage treatment plants, make the villages around it open defecation free. We plan to replicate the Sichewal model for this. We have special forces to ensure that the pollution etc. does not take place. We are also working on having some right equipment such as thrashers and skimmers to reduce the pollution etc.
No, etc. One very important factor you missed out. Behavioral change,
yes,
change in attitude of people, because otherwise we revere our rivers but we still pollute them.
Yes, ma'am.
So that's one of the most important factors.
Indeed.
Now we have global challenges which our country is facing. Can you mention some of them?
One big challenge is man terrorism.
Yes.
One big challenge is protectionism.
Yes.
Third, globally the economic growth is also still not very high as compared to pre-2008 levels. Fourthly, there are issues related to bloc formations, for example, China, Russia is one bloc. Environmental challenge is another global problem. So these are the main problems.
What about drugs?
It is.
Money laundering, trafficking.
Yes.
All these are important problems.
Yes.
Now my last question on corruption. How can we reduce corruption? We already have institutions, we also have provisions in law. How can we still then, we are still very corrupt, so how can we reduce this? Can you just give me two or three measures which you think would be useful?
Ma'am, the laws are all right, but we need more implementation, and for that we need to strengthen our regulators. So that's one. Two, I think the behavioral change is very important.
Okay.
And
never mind behavioral change here, now what else?
For corruption also we need, ma'am, to ensure that those actually found out for corruption, they must be prosecuted.
Specifically speedy prosecution, okay?
Even those who are...
What about discretionary powers?
That needs to be reduced.
That's one of the most important.
Yes, ma'am.
The rights of the people, if they are aware, that would also probably be done corruption.
The transparency, the accountability.
Good. Okay, thank you.
Central statistical organization, they have, it has come in the papers today, they have released the GDP data for the third quarter. Are you aware of that?
Yes, sir.
How much of growth has been recorded?
In the third quarter, it has been 7.2%.
7.2%. This is very significant.
Yeah.
What accounts for such a high increase?
So, one is the base effect. Because last year, this was a time when certain disruptions had come.
Right.
And because of that, there has been natural increment in this year's growth. Secondly, manufacturing sector, agriculture sector has grown over and above 4%.
All three sectors, in fact, including services.
Yes, sir.
But primarily, I think it must be, rightly said, it is the basic effect.
Yes.
Okay. What are the headwinds for the economy?
Right now it seems positive because we have, the prospects look positive because our country is gradually digitizing, there's a greater formalization of the economy.
My question is, mention the headwinds.
I'm sorry, sir, but I don't exactly know the meaning of
problem areas.
Okay. So the main problem area comes from the fact that inflation can rise in the economy, given the oil prices rising, given that the fiscal slippage is increased to a certain extent.
There is already slippage.
Yes, sir.
And anything else?
Another major problem can be that this growth has came from the base effect. It may not sustain in the future, especially because international growth rate, international protectionism all are rising. So this can be another area for concern.
Anything else which is already evident? Balance of payment?
Yes, sir. It is gradually rising.
Gradually rising or it has already risen? The trade deficit has widened?
It has risen, sir. But as far as we compare the 2007 or 8 levels, it is still much lesser than that period. So it is more manageable, but it is indeed a problematic area, sir.
Okay. Old sector, very recently government has made certain announcements, policy announcements. Are you familiar with that?
Yes, sir.
What kind of decision has been made?
Sir, the main thrust has been for the private sector to allow the mining of coal sector, not mining of coal, not just for captive purposes, but also for any other purposes.
What is the significance of this decision?
It's expected that this will increase the competition in the sector, the monopoly of CIL will reduce. And when that happens, this should increase the efficiency and the availability of coal for a power plant should improve. The overall mining efficiency, the overall improvements in this flow of technology, flow of money, etc. can or should improve further. And that should have a significant supply side as well as demand side improvements for economy.
Right. Last question. Kaveri. Recently, our Supreme Court has given its verdict. What is your take on that? How significant is that and what kind of law points have been made in the judgment?
It's a significant measure because this is the first time that Supreme Court interfered in this matter using special petition. So this can have both positive as well as adverse consequences. But given that they have also focused on saying that rivers are national heritage, national importance they have.
That's one law point they made. And anything else?
They try to make sure that Kaveri Management Board is implemented there. So we hope that the future liability due to this will reduce. And basically they expanded the ambit of the previous tribunal award to include the effect of water demand in Bangalore, the groundwater availability in Tamil Nadu region. So this is a more holistic measure. In that respect, we expect that this is...
Water demand in Bangalore is primarily on account of what?
The rising urbanization and the growth of this.
Drinking water?
Yes, sir.
So that has to take gear precedence over anything else?
Yes, sir.
What is Competition Commission of India?
So it's a regulator under the Competition Commission of India 2002, I think, which basically aims to ensure that competition levels in India are prudent and monopoly, if any, can be done away with.
Okay. Thank you.
Jharkhand presents some paradoxes. There are 2-3 major paradoxes which one sees. Can you identify those paradoxes?
I'll try to, sir. So one is the, in spite of the availability of resources, Jharkhand is not doing well. So this is a paradox from the resource point of view, and even resource curse has come.
Your statement is not correct. It's registering a 7.8% growth, and you say it is not doing well.
Over the years, sir.
What are you talking now?
The second paradox can be that even though we have a lot of demographic difference.
Anyway, that paradox doesn't seem to hold good what you're talking. That it is very rich, but it is not doing well. Economically, it's doing very well.
So,
there are other paradoxes.
One paradox is from the point of demographic dividend. We have a lot of human power available with us, but in spite of that, people are migrating abroad. In spite of that, since jobs are not being available, demographic dividend is transforming to a certain extent to demographic curse. The other paradox can be from the point of maybe environment and the availability of water. We have not been able to exploit it or utilize it to a good extent.
Constitution provides certain rights and safeguards to tribals. Can you identify constitutional provisions which give these rights and safeguards?
Yes, sir. So one is the basic principle of Article 14, 15 and 16, which focuses on equality and justice.
14 is for everyone.
Yes, sir.
14 is not for tribals alone.
Yes, sir.
Give tribal specific.
So one is the fifth schedule states. Under that, we have specific provisions for them.
What does fifth schedule do?
So fifth schedule basically says that tribals must be taken good care of, and the governor has specific power to ensure that their conditions are.
So that is not a right. You go for the rights first. What are the rights? In part 3, there are rights available to the tribals. Why don't you first talk of the rights? They have enough the rights. What are those rights?
One specific right can be maybe from the Article 29 and 30 point of view, sir. That they have a right to conserve their culture, right to establish their education.
Can be, or is it available to them?
It is available.
Can you cite any case, important case, where this right, cultural rights of tribals have been upheld by Supreme Court?
I'm not exactly sure about it.
Yeah, maybe.
Yes, sir. Even the Samantha judgment is indirectly related to that.
Which one?
The 1996 judgment, I think, sir, which said that the private miners or the private industries must not overlook the right of the tribals in the forest area.
What is the name of this case?
The Samantha or Samantha judgment.
What else? One is 29.
We have directive principles, sir. Directive principles ensure that
they don't provide a right.
Yes, sir.
I'm talking about that.
So Article 25, 26 can also be seen in that light. Then I'm not very sure, sir.
Why? 15, 16?
Yes,
where
sir.
They have rights?
Yes, sir.
19?
19, 21, they're also very important, but...
Not 20, 19.
Yes, sir.
Why is 19 relevant?
So, because it provides them a right to freedom of expression?
No. It restricts entry into tribal areas.
Yes, sir.
That is the same one.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
All right.